आप अपने आप पे ध्यान ही नहीं दे पा रहे हो बिकॉज वी डोंट हैव टाइम बिकॉज ऑफ द लाइव्स दैट वी आर लिविंग इन. व्हाट आर द टाइप ऑफ थॉट्स दैट यू हैव, यू नो, डू यू फील फुलफिल्ड, डू यू फील लाइक यू नो आई हैव अचीव्ड एवरीथिंग. वी आर इजिली एबल टू कनेक्ट विद एनीबडी हु वी वॉन्ट. लाइक सडनली आई कीप क्वेश्चनिंग माई सेल्फ, मेक इट वर्क द वे यू वॉन्ट टू मेक इट वर्क. एवरीथिंग इन दिस यूनिवर्स इज एनर्जी. Hey guys, welcome to the podcast Beyond the Peel, your journey to self-transformation. So today I'm going to talk about a thing that is really, really crucial if you want to be successful in your life. It's something that all the successful people on this planet, on this universe have in common, and that is called self-discipline. There is no surprises there. I'm sure we all know that discipline is so, so, so important to be able to call successful and achieve those goals. So I'm going to talk about a couple of tips and tricks on what might help you if you are the one who's struggling to stay disciplined even when you are having that burning desire to be successful. So if you are interested in that, do keep watching. First and foremost, what is self-discipline as a refresher? So it is about controlling your emotions and impulses to stay focused on your long-term goals, right? It is about doing what is needed to be done as opposed to what you want to do. So think of it as a muscle in your body which will help you push you towards those challenges and help you stay focused at all times in order to reach that end goal that you want to. So that is what in a very simple and a vague language is self-discipline. But why is self-discipline really important? Why do people keep chanting about self-discipline, right? First and foremost, discipline helps you stay consistent. We all know that if you've got to do something, you need to take action to be able to do something. How do you take action if at all you stay consistent on doing something repeatedly? We all know that motivation is fleeting, right? It's like that spark which sometime might be on fire and some most of the times it's not. Motivation is fleeting, but what will get you towards the end line is consistency. So if you put in consistent efforts towards something, even when you don't like it, that's when you are going to be able to complete the task that you have your eye on. So if you are disciplined, it will help you stay consistent because that is where the real progress is, right? The second reason why self-discipline is important is because it boosts your focus and productivity. Because many a times, let's be realistic, when we are trying to achieve a particular goal, take actions towards achieving that goal, we can lose focus a lot of times. We cannot be productive on all days. I am not productive on all days. I am not focused on all days. I am not motivated on all days. So all of these things are really, really common. But if a person is self-disciplined, they will be able to keep their focus on that, because if you're disciplined, you are eliminating all of the distractions and managing your time effectively. You are basically concentrating on all your priorities and getting more done in the same amount of time, which otherwise you probably are wasting on things that don't even matter, things that don't align with your with the end goal of yours. So that is the second reason why self-discipline is really, really important, because it helps you stay laser focused. It helps you be productive in whatever you are trying to accomplish. If a person is self-disciplined, the third benefit that that person has is that it helps in building good habits. In order to live your life and be able to achieve all the goals that you want to, you want to make sure that you have instilled good routines in your everyday life, because that is what is going to stay longer term with you. If you have bad habits in your routine which are not really contributing to your long-term success, it's going to be a hindrance. But if you are consistent, like if you are self-disciplined and you know that I don't need to do, you can be on the right track and you can basically install and have all those good habits in your routine, because the end goal is crystal clear in your mind. Last and not the least, the reason why self-discipline is important is because it helps you build resilience. So what does that mean is that in running behind the goals that whatever you're trying to achieve, you are going to face setbacks, you're going to face challenges, but your discipline is what's going to help you get up, face the challenge and move on to the next step, right? So I think that basically summarizes what self-discipline is, what exactly comprises of self-discipline and why is it really important for reaching the success level that you want to. Now let's look at what is it that you can do to become self-disciplined, because let us all agree that it is really crucial for your success. All right, the first thing that you can do is setting clear goals. So whatever you're trying to achieve in your life, whatever your definition of success is, make sure your goals are clear. Because if the goals are not clear and then you start something, you are going to be confused in the middle on why did I even do this, right? When you know exactly what you want to achieve, it's easier for you to stay disciplined and focused on that goal. So setting the clear intentions, setting clear goals in your life is really, really important. If there is any ambiguity along the way, you are going to get confused and basically falter and just leave it, because you're like, I don't know why I'm doing it. One day you're chasing behind something else. Other day you're chasing behind something else. Third day it's something else. So you're like, you're all over the place. You're not chasing anything, in fact. So you want to make sure whatever your goal is, whatever you're trying to be successful and what that goal is, define that goal very, very clearly in your brain, so that whenever you are in the state of confusion somewhere down the line, you refer back to that clear definition of the end goal and you then move forward towards it. So that's the very first thing that you can do. The second thing is creating a routine. Consistency, guys, there is no better alternative in your life than being consistent. You have to make sure that things that you do on your daily basis, the routine that you follow, that is towards you taking this action steps for whatever your end goal is. If you have a routine, if you are consistent in doing something, you will be disciplined, because all of those actions basically becomes habit. We all know that what is a habit? It's nothing but something that you do frequently, 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 till your mind is trained that yes, this is something that I have got to do. Why do you wake up in the morning or in a particular time frame? Why do you drink water after having a meal? Why do you have a meal the way you have a meal? Why do you study a certain way? It's that, it's your habit now that has been ingrained in your mind. So if you do not follow a routine, if you are not consistent and doing something on the other, which is related to your end-term goal, you will not be able to build habit. To build habit, you need to do something even if you don't like it. Let it be a small progress that you make every day. Make sure you're making some progress so that when you look back, you are doing something or the other to achieve that goal. If for some reason you're not able to do it for a long period of time, maybe it's a wrong goal to chase. Maybe that goal is not meant for you. So you've got to realize that sooner rather than later. So build a routine, set a clear goal which you really feel happy about, which you know that will make you happy. Make sure your goal is attached to the emotion that you want to feel. Happy is a very generic one. There are many emotions underneath a happy emotion. So make sure you're clear on what your goal is. Make sure you are waking up every day from your bed to accomplish that goal and set the routine and do that over and over and over again, so that your mind is trained that now this has become a habit. And that's how you will be able to take the inspired action towards whatever you want to achieve in your life. The third thing that you can do to stay disciplined is eliminate distractions. This is so, so, so important, because I think whatever you want to achieve, there are some things which you will not like, right? It's very, very common. Make sure you find an alternative to things which are causing frictions in your life. Distractions could be things that you don't like doing, or it could be people who are not really aligned to what you want to do, people who are discouraging you at all times. Just identify what those distractions are for you and make sure you are eliminating them, because your long-term success is what matters at the end of the day. So identify what are the things you're calling as distractions when it comes to you taking inspired action towards reaching that end goal, right? It could be as simple as your phone. Each time you sit down and do something for your goal, your phone starts ringing, there are notifications, just turn off the notifications. So whatever that distraction could be, it could be as simple as a notification, or it could be as big as removing some people from your life who are just not letting you move forward. So identify what those distractions are and just get rid of them. The number fourth practice that you can follow to become self-disciplined is practicing self-control. So a lot of times, because of the older habits that we've built, we tend to do something which might not necessarily be the right thing to do for the goal that you're trying to chase. So make sure that slowly and steadily you are practicing self-control. You are not doing the things that do not align with those long-term goals and only focusing on things that matter. So it could be as simple as, you know, resisting the urge to check social media frequently. It could be resisting the urge to talk non-stop for hours on topic that doesn't really align with you or basically drains your energy. It could be anything and everything. So make sure you practice self-control, because there's going to be a lot of times you will fall into the older habit trap, which might not be serving you well when it comes to you achieving that long-term goal. So it's important we practice that control every now and then. And then last but not the least, in order to stay disciplined, it's a good practice to stay accountable. You could have an accountability partner in your friend, in your family member, in a mentor you are working with. It could be anybody. You could be accountable to Instagram as an example, because the way we humans work, that if we have some sort of a support system, we do tend to move forward when we get that validation. So find who that accountability partner for you is and just be sort of accountable, right? And that's how you could be taking inspired action for the goals that you want to achieve. So these are a couple of tips that I practice all the time. I'm not saying that I am like the ultimate definition of being a self-disciplined person. I do falter sometimes as well, but these are majorly the things that I follow and practice, and I'm getting better each day with. So that is what I wanted to share, because self-discipline, it's not like a one-time thing. It's a lifelong thing that will take you towards the end. It is a skill that can be developed with practice. So that is a good news. If you think you've not been disciplined till now, there's no problem. You can literally start at any day you start thinking to change your ways of working. It's not definitely easy, because we are breaking free from the older patterns, but it definitely is rewarding at the end, because once you see the fruits of all the hard work and labor that you're putting through the act of being self-disciplined, it will all be worth it towards the end. I can say that with experience. So if at all you struggle with this, I hope this video has been helpful to you. Let me know what is your major roadblock for you when it comes to being disciplined in life, and let's take it from there. Until then, I'm going to see you all next week with another interesting topic. Bye-bye.